Sorry about that. Caught me off guard. We're ready.
Yes, Gregor, we're rolling. From the top, Gregor.
Hello, folks. Today's discussion is going to be about modern journalism. Very much the driving force behind social and political outrage.
Cut.
I mean, discourse.
Why on earth did you say outrage? That's not what it says.
It said it on the telephone.
Oh, don't give me that.
What am I going to do about that?
Gregor.
Where were we? Ah, yes. Today's show is all about taking the news head on. Of course, journalism is more than just the news, but whilst we reset the studio, here are a few things that rhyme with the wee compass-friendly word. Shoes. Cruise. Views. Snooze.
Booze.
And coos.
Whilst coos is technically incorrect, it is the vastly superior method of referring to female cattle. Simple. And speaking of simple, I'm...
We're.
Yes, we're going to make modern journalism simple. Simple to understand, simple to appreciate, and simple to ridicule.
Hey, you. Yeah, you. Are you ready to learn? I hope you are, because I'm ready to teach you. Teach you all night long.
Is there a problem, Gregor?
BGB, you can't say things like that.
Oh, can't I?
No, you're blooming. You can't. This is a serious show for serious people.
Grumble, useless. Gregor, can we just go for another one, please? I'm not sure that was quite what we wanted.
Journalism can be defined as the work of collecting, writing, and publishing or broadcasting of news stories and articles. Its mass market origins can be traced back to China, where printed text is known to have existed in the first millennium AD. Since then, the European invention and perfection of the printing press has seen the craft rapidly grow to eventually form the faultless journalistic practices we know today.
As alluded to before, there is more to journalism than just the news. In fact, there are five types of journalism. Investigative, news, reviews, columns, and feature writing.
Page 3.
Unbelievable. Anyway, before I'm rudely interrupted again, I better appease my better half by skipping ahead to the topic of broadsheet versus tabloid press. Oh, but if you did want to know more about the five types of journalism, you can visit the link below.
Nickety knock. Knockers.
Fine, fine. Okay, so it's fairly well known that there's a newspaper divide between broadsheets and tabloids. Broadsheet. Broadsheets is where you'll likely find a more formal take on current events. It uses its pleases and thank yous and says, may I go to the elitist brigade? As opposed to, can I go to the elitist brigade? Examples of broadsheets are the Daily Telegraph, the Times, the New York Times, and the Guardian.
Page 3.
Right, all right. So, to counter broadsheets are the tabloids. They are more sensationalist, easier to digest. Some have even become famous for featuring supposedly attractive females in scant clothing. There, Gabby.
Yes.
Many a modern newspaper or article will often enter the wonderful world of debates, both social and political, giving their views based on the opinions and beliefs of their readers.
Now here's a hot take. What if the newspaper or article is actually the driver of the opinions and
influences the beliefs.
They would never.
Wouldn't they? Famed Russian novelist Alexander Solzhenitsyn once said, "Mediocre journalists simply make headlines of their conclusions, which suddenly become generally accepted." And, well, if you can't beat him, might as well join him, eh, Gregor?
Oh, Beachy Bee, get back in your box!
Oh, my pleasure.
Wait, what are you typing? What's going on? Clickbait heresy!
Clickbait is a word you commonly hear in association with news headlines or video titles, and it's designed to make you click a link to read the article or to watch the video. Some examples are: elephants learn to fly using this one simple trick. Here's the secret that 99% of jailed criminals don't want you to know. Cosmetic surgeons weigh in on, does her bum look big in that dress?
Indeed, headlines alone are powerful tools, and just like all things in life, journalism's transition to a digital ad-focused platform has created more need for tabloid sensationalism to stay competitive and keep readers reading. To quote novelist Robert Black... No! Not that Robert Black! Everyone with a phone is a journalist.
Now there's something we can agree on.
Anyway, to add, journalist Louis Yako made the conclusion that our understanding of what is really newsworthy is a misunderstanding. Now, I think this is very appropriate in the modern world of journalism. Take a look at this recent article from the BBC.
Well, they might be bickering about Meghan, but...
Blimey.
And? I talked to a black and white Sean Connery wannabe. Where's the news articles about that?
Absolutely shameful.
Quite. Headline madness at its finest. But there we go. Modern journalism made very simple for you, and probably what you already knew, except this time summarised by an unusual Scotsman.
Unusual? Oh. That's what you are.
Sure. Anyway, if you didn't know already, I'm also a journalist. However, you won't find my articles anywhere, as they were censored by a clown.
And if you want more, you can join our Patreon for extra content and flirty banter.
And remember, it's not all black and white, but most of it's a load of shit.
Grumble, grumble, rubbish, grumble.